ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्या नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयत्। नष्टाप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। हरि ओम तत्सत्। कैंटो 3 स्टेटस क्यू चैप्टर 1 टाइटल क्वेश्चंस बाय विद्रोह वर्स नंबर 43। नूनं रूपानां त्री मदोत्पतानां महीं मुहोश्चालयतां चामुभि वदात् प्रपन्नार्तिजीर्षयेशो अपि उपैक्षताघं भगवान् कुरूणाम्। नूनं रूपानां त्रिमदोत्पतानां महीं मुहोश्चालयतां चामुभि वदात् प्रपन्नार्तिजीर्षयेशो अपि उपैक्षता अगम भगवान् कुरूणाम्। नूनं रूपानां त्रिमदोत्पदानां महीमोश्चालयतां चामुवि वदात् प्रपन्नार्तिजीर्षयेशो अपि उपैक्षता अगम भगवान् कुरूणाम्। Word to word translation. Nunam, of course, Rupana, of the kings, three, there. Mada, Utpatanam, going astray out of false pride. Mahim, earth. Mu, constantly. Chalayatam, agitating. Chamubi, by the movement of soldiers. Vadat, from the act of killing. Prapanna, surrendered. Arti Jihir Shaya, willing to relieve the distress of the sufferers. Isha, the Lord, Api, in spite of. Upayikshata, waited. Agam, offenses. Bhagavan, the Supreme Lord. Kurunam, of the Kurus. Translation by Jivangir S.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada ki jaya. Despite his being the Lord and being always willing to relieve the distress of sufferers, he, Krishna, refrained from killing the Kurus. Although they committed all sorts of sins, and although he saw other kings constantly agitating the earth by their strong military movements carried out under the dictation of three kinds of false pride. Please repeat. Despite his being the Lord and being always willing to relieve the distress of sufferers, he, Krishna, refrained from killing the Kurus. Although they committed all sorts of sins, and although he saw other kings constantly agitating the earth by their strong military movements carried out under the dictation of three kinds of false pride. As declared in Bhagavad Gita, the Lord appears in the mortal world to execute his much needed mission of killing the miscreants and giving protection to the suffering faithful. In spite of that mission, Lord Krishna tolerated the insult to Draupadi by the Kurus and the injustices perpetrated against the Pandavas, as well as insults to himself. The question may be raised, why did he tolerate such injustices and insults in his presence? Why did he not chastise the Kurus immediately? When Draupadi was insulted in the assembly by the Kurus by their attempt to see her naked in the presence of all, the Lord protected Draupadi by supplying an unlimited length of clothing, but he did not chastise the insulting party immediately. This silence of the Lord did not mean, however, that he excused the offenses of the Kurus. There were many other kings on the earth who had become very proud of three kinds of possessions: wealth, education, and followers. And they were constantly agitating the earth by movements of military strength. The Lord was just waiting to get them together on the battlefield of Kurukshetra and kill them all at one time, just to make a shortcut in his killing mission. Godless kings are heads of state. When puffed up by the advancement of material wealth and education and increase of population, always make a show of military strength and give trouble to the innocent. When Lord Krishna was personally present, there were many such kings all over the world, and he thus arranged for the battle of Kurukshetra. In his manifestation of Viswarupa, the Lord expressed his mission of killing as follows: I have willingly descended on the earth in my capacity of inexorable time in order to decrease the unwanted population. I shall finish all those who have assembled here, except you, the Pandavas. This killing does not wait for you to take part in it. It is already arranged. All will be killed by me. If you want to become famous as the hero of the battlefield and thus enjoy the booty of war, then, O Savyasachi, just become the immediate cause of this killing and thus take the credit. I have already killed all the great warriors, Bhishma, Drona, Jayadrata, Karna, and many other great generals. Do not worry. Fight the battle and be famous as a great hero. Bhagavad Gita 11.32-34. The Lord always wants to see his devotee as the hero of some episode which he himself performs. He wanted to see his devotee and friend Arjuna is the hero of the battle of Kurukshetra, and thus he waited for all the miscreants of the world to assemble. That and nothing else is the explanation of his waiting. Wow. Yeah. Om Ajnanat Mirandasya Gnananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Meditam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दिनतारिणं परमानंदमाधवं श्रीचैतन्यैश्वरं वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। श्री चैतन्य मनोविष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकम्। श्री गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। श्री प्रभुपाद की जय। गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे ऑन कैंटो 3 चैप्टर 1 क्वेश्चंस बाय विद्रा वर्स नंबर 43। हियर Vidura is discussing with Uddhava, asking questions, and we see this similarly. Yudhishthira Maharaj is asking, when Arjuna returned from Dwaraka after Krishna left the planet, he was waiting. Yudhishthira Maharaj was very much worried, and he is already seeing the symptoms of Kali, already the seasonal changes and in terms of people's behaviors, religious principles. So he is seeing, and he was very much worried about Arjuna not being returned. Then he returns, we'll go through that. So here these specific words, many important words are used, especially two of them. Three madhotpatanam, that is the three types of false pride. Then we have see. And also it is mentioned, prapanna arti jihirshaya, surrendered. Those who are surrendered, Lord is willing to relieve the distress of the sufferers. And Lord has waited to kill all of them at once. So from 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, we can see so how these various types of pride is mentioned in the example of Nalakuvera and Manigriva, how they were arrogant, puffed up with pride from the aristocracy and madness for wealth. We also see the Brahmanas who are performing the sacrifice when Krishna and Balram were hungry. They asked for food and Krishna and Balram sent associates to ask them to bring some food. And then Brahmanas were not ready, they were busy in sacrifices. So where it is mentioned their callousness towards Krishna because of one's position, their birth in Varnashrama, being a Brahmana attached to that particular designation. And then we also see in terms of the Aristas or a bull demon, Shastra is mentioning as Bhaktivinoda Thakur and others, pride arising from indulging in false religious invented by cheaters, which is causing the neglect of the bhakti. And we also see the Trinavrata whirlwind demon representing the false pride arising from material scholarship rise to the bogus philosophies. And we also see from Indra's thinking, he was very much proud and puffed up, thinking that I am the supreme, and he started creating so many troubles for the Vrajavasis. So in this way, here Prabhupada is explaining that Janmaiswarya Srutta Srivi Yadamana Madhapuman, as Kunti Maharani is praying in his in our prayers when Krishna was about to leave to Dwaraka from Hastinapur after the Kurukshetra war. So by birth, by their wealth, by Janma Aishwarya, Aishwarya is wealth, Janma is birth, and their position also, just like this Varnashrama being a Kshatriya, and material wealth, Aishwarya, opulence, Sruta means education and beauty. Here Prabhupada is quoting that in the purport, material wealth, and their birth, and their associates having a military strength. They were puffed up, so many kings were puffed up, but Krishna has waited for them to, and then so Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining how to remove this kind of pride, false pride. So we should worship the holy name and cry very humbly before the Lord and ask for admitting our defeat. Then Lord will nullify all the contaminations of what we have. And then in 17th chapter also we see there are different types of three modes of material nature, basically divisions of three modes of material. There also it is mentioned for the sacrifices and charity and austerity. People perform sacrifices under the three modes. Those who are out of false pride, people may perform sacrifices. And also the charity, out of false pride and looking for the material benefits, they may perform charity. And this all will cause the false pride. And also the austerity, people may perform out of pride. And that's why devotion service, especially when we are performing, we are not supposed to disclose what we are doing. Oh, I am chanting this many rounds, or I am doing these many services, and this or that. So this is not supposed to be disclosed. We will see that from Lord Krishna instructing on those points, on so many points on how to remove this false pride extensively, exhaustively. Lord Krishna is instructing Uddhava in 11th canto. So these are the very important instructions. And Prabhupada is quoting also this Nonam Pramatta Kurute Vikarna and Indriya Pritaya Apnoti. In that verse also we see Lord Rishabhadev is instructing his sons, 100 sons, before giving the kingdom. And Prabhupada is explaining, yes, as Lord Krishna is sitting and everybody's heart, and he's arranging so many, it is as a yantra, as a machines. We are thinking that we are this machine, like a nice, beautiful car, like Mercedes-Benz or BMW. Thinking that I am nicely enjoying, comfortably sitting in that, thinking that I am the supreme, I am the enjoyer. So, and this is resulting in false pride and getting attached to so many worldly things. So, only way we can, the problem is, he does not admit that I am the servant of the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna fully. So that's what is causing this false pride. And Prabhupada is explaining, as soon as, because he is not hearing what I am saying, as a Paramatma within the heart, sitting in that machine, whatever body is taking up every life, I am telling, giving instructions as a spiritual master, giving instructions as a Shastra, giving instructions as a Chaitanya Guru, as Paramatma, but he is not hearing what I am saying. So then automatically, Asriddha Dhana Purusha, Dharma Shastra Paranta, Aprapya Mam Nivartante, Mrityu Samsara Vartamane. Naturally, he has to take again another birth. So that it is very important to understand that. So we are always, core identity must be always be kept in each and every day, each and every activity. More we remember having the designation Sarva Upadhi Vinirmuktam Tat Paratvena Nirmalam Rushikesh Rushikesh Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. Only when we give up these designations, we should perform. That doesn't mean we renounce our duties, job and family and or community or temple duties. And we should do perform, but always identifying with that core principle, Jivera Swarupoi Nitya Krishna Das. That is the main important point. And we go to Lord Krishna is giving instruction to Uddhava, beautiful verses, where he's explaining this pride on the level of body and mind and intelligence. And then he's giving so many instructions. And I want to read this because this has a lot of details and this gives a great benefit to all of us. So first, Lord Krishna is instructing. One can give up the false pride and prestige. His first instruction is giving. By seeing me and my pure devotees, by touching, by serving, by worshipping, by offering prayers and glorification and obeisances to me and my pure devotees, is the first instruction. So that means this must be done regularly. And then next instruction is giving, whatever one acquires, he should offer to me. Because constantly we are thinking we are the enjoyer, even though we have been told we are not this body, we are not the enjoyer. Because we are developing so much attachment, we are not offering to Krishna whatever we have, even whatever on a regular basis, this must be done. And this we see in that in 64 instructions of Rupa Goswami, Nectar Devotion. And the festival days, on regular days also we need to offer. And festival days like Purushottam month, Damodar month, we always constantly has to think what we can offer, what I can do for the Supreme Lord's pleasure and Guru's pleasure. What can I offer within my capacity, whether physically or by whatever we have in terms of the uplands, we can offer so many things. It can be very simple things, offering tulsi leaves. It can be basic things, but time to time we forget the basic things also. That is where is causing us to become the enjoyer rather than Krishna being the enjoyer. So that's why he's mentioning, whatever one acquires, offer to me. And then further Krishna is mentioning, as my eternal servant should give oneself completely to me. That means we have to dedicate completely. Then further he is mentioning, always discuss my beautiful pastimes and enjoy life by particularly in performing festivals such as Janmashtami and participate in singing, dancing, playing musical instruments and discussing about me with others and other devotees. So that, and we do, CNJ is famous for performing festivals throughout the year, and sometimes people may think, why are we performing these festivals? We can just perform 3 or 4, why do we need to elaborately perform? Because Krishna is the enjoyer, so we need to offer whatever capacity we got, we should, and it is giving opportunity, and Sri Prabhupada has emphasized this, and he has given this opportunity for us to offer whatever we have in these special days, especially these are the, we try to celebrate our birthday in so many ways. We always remember our kids' birthday, family birthday, so many birthdays. But same way, if we can do that much more, really eager and utmost eagerness to serve and wait for months ahead to when Janmashtami is going to come, when the next festival is, we have to eagerly wait within the heart. That greediness must be there. What can I do this for this festival? So this must be, that's what here Krishna is telling. Performing this festival by singing, dancing, playing musical instruments and discussing with others and devotees. So this is very important points. And then he is also saying further, serving all the devotees and performing and various ceremonies and going to pilgrimages and make various offerings, observe all regular annual festivals by attending ceremonies and pilgrimages and make offerings. We should try our best. We may have so many other commitments. At least some part of the time we should try to attend, even if we are busy with office or some other things. And we should schedule our vacations and all those accordingly. Sometimes, many times we see that many are missing in the key festival, most important festivals. Think about it. And so whatever possible way we can avoid it, or schedule in that way. It's very difficult, I know, balancing, but it is very, very much needed. Otherwise, we are missing the whole point of life. So as here Krishna is mentioning to Uddhava, so just like, do we miss our family important marriages within our own family, or very important persons, or any important event, we don't miss it. We somehow or other juggle and attend it. Then how can we miss the most important festivals of the Lord? So it's, we should try our best to not to miss it, not to, and also we should participate actively, not just only attending it. But what can I do? We should be eager for coming forth, rather than somebody is asking, what can you do? Are you available? So not, this should be coming from our heart directly. That's what Lord is looking. How much time, how eager he is. Otherwise, the Lord is ready to give material benefits and heavenly planet, some kind of enjoyment. He's not going to give the pure bhakti, because we are not ready for it. We are not eager for it. Then he's further performing, further telling, vows, and one should perform, take vows such as Ekadasi and others, important things on the appearance days and disappearance days of the spiritual masters and the Supreme Lord. So we should take the vows in thinking to do more service, remembering somehow or other whatever types of devotion service, 9 types of devotion, whatever way, that should be the more priority than performing austerity or other rules and regulations. Smartavyasya satato Vishnu smartavyasya najatu. That should be the prime rule for in each and every activity, any devotion we perform. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. That should be the core principle. Then further Krishna is mentioning, support the installation of deities and work towards building temples and proper courts on that. Like, just like we have built Mayapur Chandrodaya Mandir, almost example Prabhupada is giving. And flowers, build nice flower gardens, special areas. So like we see in Vrindavan, Mayapur, and other temples, and we are trying to do that here also, as a vegetable garden and flowers. Vishnu Prabhu and other wonderful devotees are doing this wonderful services. We should try to assist, we should try to help them, and we should try to do whatever we can within our capacity. So, and further Krishna is mentioning, as my humble servant, without duplicity, this is much, is also very, very important. We neglect that, we'll be busy in so many things, we neglect this. As my humble servant, without duplicity, help and clean the temple, first thing, sweeping. Fully sweep it, then remove the dust and cleanse with water and cow dung. We may not be able to do it, but as much as possible we can sprinkle. Then the dry the temple. This must be done regularly as in my humble menial servant. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is exhibited, showed by his own personal example in by performing this Gundicha Marjan. So we're also trying to come up with various cleaning, we're trying to see. So one person cannot do this, so we all have to come together and schedule in like that. If many devotees come forward, then we can do that. So right now I'm scheduling for the deity kitchen, stove and other things. In a month I'm assigning various devotees. I'm sure in various departments we can do this cleaning, not waiting for any specific festival or specific month to come, but rather we should schedule this, so that this can be done regularly. So it is not mandate of deity ministry. It is the mandate coming from Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, and directly Krishna is instructing to Uddhava, either cleaning the temple, cleansing and sweeping, dusting and removing the dust, cleansing with water and cow dung, and the altar and everything. The altar takes much more priority. So that this includes not only residents, but we all have to collectively do. If you depend too much on residents only, then this will not be done. Then it's ultimately, it is causing us the problem of not being fully surrendered to the lotus feet of Supreme Lord and our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada and spiritual masters. Further, Krishna is mentioning, sprinkle scented water and decorate with mandalas. So we should always also offer, whenever we do the Srungar, whenever we do 16 Upacharas, in the morning time, we should try to offer the scent and Chandan to the Lord and spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada and spiritual master and devotees. They should be also remembered, because the ultimate, all these things are for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord. So we should try to offer all these articles. And never, Krishna is mentioning, never advertise devotional activities to others. So which means that is causing also false pride. More we discuss about what we do, unless somebody asks what your day look like, or somehow to improve for others to practice or learning, then that's fine. But otherwise, we shouldn't be advertising about what we do. And then further, Krishna is mentioning, never use lamps offered to me for other purposes, because there is a need of lighting. Electricity is gone, so that I can use the lamps or whatever paraphernalia we use for the Lord. We should be very careful not to utilize that. And Krishna is mentioning that. Further, Krishna is mentioning, never offer to me anything that has been offered to or used by others. Whatever is most desired, and this is also very important, the last instruction, whatever is most desired by one within this material world, whatever is most dear to oneself, one should offer that very thing to me. Such offering qualifies one for spiritual life. This is the most important instruction. So whatever is most desired by one within this material world, and whatever is most dear to oneself, one should offer that very thing to me. Such offering qualifies one for eternal life. So, already 6:58, a lot more to come. Maybe let me see a few more things. So, this is from Lord Krishna's instruction of Uddhava, verse number, canto 11, chapter 11, verse number 34 to 41. So, I encourage highly to read and meditate on this. For all of us, it is very beneficial, so that we can really build this vibrant community with this thought process, so that we become the recipients of the mercy of His Divine Grace, Sri Prabhupada and the Supreme Lord, by following His instructions here. And we see also from Arjuna's instructions, when Arjuna came back, all his powers, everything was removed. As while coming back from Dwaraka, Krishna left the planet. And then so Arjuna, what is happening is, the cowherd boys are kidnapping the queens of Dwaraka. This is after the Krishna left the planet. Then Arjuna tried to, because Gandhi was born, and he tried to do his best to fight, but he couldn't fight against the cowherd boys. And then that time, while he is coming back in this way, thinking, what has happened to me? Then he realized and he remembered immediately the Lord Krishna's instruction, and then is describing this to Yudhishthira Maharaj. Yudhishthira Maharaj obviously asked the same way like Vidura asked. Then that's why there it is mentioned in this particular chapter, 15th chapter of first canto. Pandavas are 100% devoted fully. So that's why those who are exclusively devoted to me, I am ready to serve them, ready to take care of them, ready to protect them all the times. So there is no one should be puffed up for his powers borrowed from the Lord. Sane men feel obliged to Lord, should be feeling obliged to Lord for such benefactories, and must utilize power in the service, such power can be withdrawn any time. Just like Prabhupada gives example, kids may build nice temples or different things on the sand and the ocean, on the bank of the ocean when we go to beach. And then after some time, its time has come, and by the water, it can be destroyed any time like that. Or the electric powerhouse, suddenly power stops. So till that time, power is coming nicely. We are able to see and we are able to utilize that heat and light. But suddenly a transformer, the powerhouse removes the power. That's it. So the same way, so time, life can go off at any time. We can leave this body at any time. So Lord Krishna can switch off at any time. And Arjuna is feeling that. And Arjuna immediately remembered Krishna and how he helped him in so many ways. That is 701. So much more to say on these Vidura's asking questions. How Yudhishthira Maharaj and great devotees Arjuna and Kunti Maharani, each one is a great devotee, and so many instructions from each of their life. So I will stop here. Thank you very much for patiently listening. Andhra Srimad Bhagavatam ki jaya, Shukopad ki jaya, Gaur Bhaktam ki jaya.
Thank you very much, Krishna Prabhu.
Gaur Shukopad.